50 soundproofing products that you can use. Yes, and there's actually more than 50 soundproofing products out there that you can use to soundproof anything in your house, but these are the 50 that you can just go out, buy right now. They're not complicated. I'll give you a brief description on each of these products and a little bit of a ballpark price of these products in the US to give you an idea of what you're buying. And I also have a link in the description below of my Amazon storefront, so it's easier for you to just go there and buy what you need. Well, let's not waste too much time. So the first one is acoustical sealant. It's something that you add around windows, around doors, around walls, anywhere that there's a crack where you would typically use caulking. The thing is, a lot of caulking, cheap caulking, something that is not made of silicone at least, usually cracks over time. It doesn't take much for a house to shift, vibrate, and it cracks. And those cracks will not only let in light, but it also lets in noise. And acoustical sealant will prevent that. It stays rubbery over time. And the only thing is right now acoustical sealant is a little bit pricier because a lot of products out there that has the word acoustic or soundproof, it just gives the manufacturer a little bit more reasons to raise the price. So acoustical sealant is a great product. I still use it for different types of applications, but just know that one tube of this can cost you between $20 and $30. So it has gone up in price a little bit, but you can go right with number two. It's called Red Devil Caulking. Red Devil Caulking is made of silicone, so it remains flexible over time, just like acoustical caulking, but at a fraction of a price, at only around $5, $6 a tube. So that makes your soundproofing job a lot less expensive. Add this just like the acoustical sealant where noise comes through. Number three is green glue compound. The compound is a little bit different than the sealant. The compound is what you add in between, you sandwich it in between two layers of drywall to create a very thin barrier. Now, the thing is with this, you have to add two tubes of green glue per sheet of drywall. You just add it on the sheet of drywall, basically a random pattern. And after it's applied, you add your second layer of drywall over top of it. And what green glue says it does is that it transforms the sound waves into heat once it hits it. But physics will tell you that you can add pretty much anything in between those two layers of drywall of that consistency, and it will basically turn the sound waves into heat. A tube of green glue acoustical compound is going to run you between $20 and $30 per tube, depending on where you live and where you're ordering it from. Green glue or an acoustical compound is more like a finishing touch. Finishing touch should be a lot cheaper, like number four, which is carpet glue. Yeah, carpet glue. You can add carpet glue just the same way as you add an acoustical compound, and you'll essentially get close or the same results. I've tried it and I've seen no difference in results versus just using regular carpet glue and green glue. But not all carpet glue are created the same. So the one that I use and the one that I recommended in the video that you're seeing right now on your screen is the Roberts 6700. So go with that. One little canister is about $5, $6, $7 depending on where you live. Let's go to number five. Number five is a door sweep. Let's just jump right into the doors. Door sweeps are used to basically seal the gap at the bottom of the door, preventing noise to come in. You can have an inch gap at the bottom of the door. And of course, they say just a crack lets about 50% of the noise back into the room. That's a pretty big crack to let noise in. Now, yes, it will restrict airflow going into the room, so you should know that. But the door sweep that I recommend is a U-shaped door sweep. And what I like about this is you can just slide it in and just cut them to size. It's about $10, $12 for that. And the next one is an automatic door bottom. Now, these ones are a little bit more expensive. They range around $80 to $100. But as you close the door, it automatically drops down. When they open the door, it comes up. So what's nice about this, if you don't want to completely seal the bottom of the door, if you just leave the door open just a crack, the bottom of the door is not sealed. It's still open. Number seven is a weather strip. What's nice with weather strips, you can use this to soundproof a door, a window, and what I would recommend is to buy the self-adhesive weather strip. Just make sure that it's clean and dry where you apply it. Basically, where you apply it, as you can see on your screen, where you apply it is where the door meets the casing, so it creates that seal. If you go to your door and you just grab the doorknob and you wobble the door and it wobbles quite a lot, adding this to the door will make the door tighter. It will seal that gap. One easy trick to see if there's cracks around your door is just to turn all the lights off and then turn the light on the other side of the door and see if there's any light bleeding all around the door, which usually there is, then it wouldn't be a bad idea to add a weather strip around the door to create a better seal, and you'll notice that your door won't wobble anymore. Just, you can even go a step further and spend around $50 for a metal door seal kit. Now these door seal kits are more permanent because you actually have to attach them, you have to screw them around the door casing, and it creates a really good seal. Like, it's made of rubber with a metal casing, and when the door closes, there's not much noise that comes through around that door anymore. I made some sound tests. I'll have links in the description below of some of the videos that I kind of mentioned in this video, so make sure to go watch those after if you want to see a little bit of the actual sound test of some of these products. Next one for the door is an acoustic door panel. Now, an acoustic door panel, these type of door panels are custom made for your door and are packed with a dense soundproofing material like fiberglass and mass loaded vinyl. I tested one a few years back and was surprised at how much noise is actually blocked. These are also good if you want to make the room sound a little bit better, since they also absorb sound and are temporary, so you can easily attach and remove them when not in use. Now, number 11 is a acoustic door muffler. Now, it's known as a doorknob or latch silencer. These are soft padded covers designed to fit over doorknobs or latches, specifically in baby's room, or dampen the noise generated when the noise closes or latches shut. Next one is to help soundproof a wall, which is a resilient channel. A resilient channel is a specialized construction component used for soundproofing in walls and ceilings. It consists of a thin, flexible metal strip with a series of regular spaced, closely spaced holes or perforations. Resilient channels are installed horizontally or vertically on the framing of walls or ceilings before attaching the drywall or other wall coverings. What it does, it decouples the drywall from the studs, so basically makes a floating wall. And its primary function is to stop impact noise. So there's two types of noise. There's impact noise and there's airborne noise. Airborne noise is, I'm talking, that's airborne noise. But impact noise is when people are walking around, the actual impact, that noise is a lot harder to soundproof. And resilient channel will cost you between $100 and $300, depending on how big the area is. So the next one is something like resilient channel, but they're called sound isolation clips. And they're a little bit more expensive than resilient channel, but they're easier to install and much harder to mess up than the resilient channel. Sound isolation clips also perform better at reducing sound, more so than resilient channel. They're just little clips, and you install the drywall over top of them, and each clips are rated to support over 30 pounds. So you can still add two layers of drywall and have it a little bit heavy, and the clips will still suffice. And these clips for a pack of 50, it's around $100. Next one is acoustic insulation. Something like Rockwool Safe and Sound. This video is not sponsored by them. It's not sponsored by anybody. I just mentioned them because I've used it in the past and I find that it works pretty darn good. The difference between acoustical insulation and your regular pink fiberglass, yes, the price is denser and better at absorbing and dampening sound waves, making it more effective at reducing airborne and also a little bit of impact noise. What's also nice is that this type of insulation is a lot less prone to rot and to get wet and to absorb moisture. Next one on the list, number 15, is soundproof drywall. Yes, there is such a thing, but it is about double the price as regular drywall. But something like Quiet Rock consists of several layers, including a dense gypsum core and viscoelastic sound absorbing compound, something like Green Glue Acoustical Compound, something like that, which absorbs and dissipates sound waves. These added layers and materials makes it substantially thicker and denser than regular drywalls. And they're more comparable to the next one on the list, which is a 5/8 inch drywall. Typically, your wall would be a 1/2 inch drywall, and if you are soundproofing a wall, instead of ripping out your old drywall, I would just suggest adding an extra layer of drywall, 5/8 inch, and you'll see a better noise reduction than just adding another 1/2 inch layer of drywall. 5/8 inch is more expensive, not by much, than 1/2 inch drywall, but it is a lot less expensive than your soundproofing drywalls. Number 17, putty pads. Yes, putty pads. What are putty pads? Well, putty pads were constructed as a fire prevention. They would wrap the electrical outlet boxes before the wall was completely installed with this stuff. As you can see, electrical boxes has a lot of holes to let the wires in and out. Typically, we don't cover those holes. you can cover them with putty pads, and if there's a small fire caused by some type of electrical short inside that box, that putty pad is going to contain that little fire for as long as it can. So if you have two rooms back to back and you have two electrical outlets, people don't realize how much noise actually goes through the electrical outlet boxes because there's usually no insulation between rooms in a house. But the drawback is that your wall has to be open. If your wall is already finished, then you can't really add the putty pads. But they're cheap. They're only about $7 each. Number 18 is backer rod. If the space between the drywall and the electrical box is a little bit too big, you can use a backer rod. You just tuck that into that gap, sealing that gap, and then you just seal the rest with acoustical caulking, and then you're good to go. They're quite inexpensive, just a few dollars for a roll, and you don't need that much. Number 19 is a soundproof vent. You know those vents above doors? Well, you can buy a product to add in the vent that will drown out the noise but will still let noise in. But the beauty of this is you can actually build one yourself. It's called a soundproof maze. And what you do is quite simple. You just build this little box, or if you can't build a box, you just build it inside the wall between both rooms where that vent is. And you have that opening where noise easily gets through. Now what a sound maze does, it's you just add some spacers so the sound waves has a hard time going through, but it's still letting air in and out. Number 20, soundproof windows. The only difference is it comes with the frame and everything is sealed. And usually they make them with double or triple pane window. You have to completely replace the window and add that. This is basically what they have. If you go to an airport or hotel, you notice that if you're in your room, you can't really hear the planes land. Open your sliding doors just a crack, you'll hear everything. And then you just close it up and you hear nothing. These are quite expensive. These are in the hundreds, if not thousands of dollars. Number 21, which is double or triple pane windows. What the difference is with these types of windows, it's instead of just having one layer of glass, you have two or three layers of glass with a little space in between, just an air gap. They usually have an inert gas in it, but you'll have to pay a few hundred dollars, depending on the size of the window, to get that change to double or triple. But if you don't want to go that far, you can also buy a window insert. What's nice about these window inserts is you just take the measurements, you send them those numbers, and then they send you the insert. It's all custom made. If you just have a small window, it'll only cost you a few hundred dollars. If you have a big window like mine, then it was $700, maybe $800. One thing that I found in my test is that if you have a single pane window, it will work very well. But if you have a double or triple pane window, I'd skip it and just add number 23, sound deadening curtains. And the difference between these types of curtains and just regular curtains, these curtains have three layers. In the middle, you have a piece of black felt. Usually this felt is really made to block out the sun, but it helps, blocks noise and absorbs noise. You can go a step further with number 24. It's a window panel. It's pretty close to the same as a acoustic door panel, like the one I talked about earlier. You just velcro it on the window casing and then you don't have too much noise coming from around the window, and they cost a few hundred dollars. Next one is moving blankets. Same thing. Moving blankets is a lot thicker than curtains, and all that stuff inside that makes the moving blanket more durable helps blocking noise. You can also hang them on the wall to make the room sound better. That's what they do in a lot of recording studios. That's how it makes the room sound better. Next one is magnetic vent cover. You can sometimes hear through the vents. If you have that vent already closed anyway, then just add a cover. It's not gonna make that much of a difference, but it will make a difference in noise transfer. Number 27 is a thermal insulated door curtain. They're around $80. Now these are a lot more plush than the door panels that I was talking about. They will work better at absorbing noise within the room, but they will also block some noise from coming inside the room. They're just not as thick, but they are a lot cheaper. Number 28, staying at the doors, is an acoustic door hinge. These are specialized hinges made to reduce noise generated when doors are opened or closed. These hinges are around $20 to $50 each. Now this one I like. Number 29, DIY window plug. Last video I made is a DIY window plug. Now these, it's not really something that you can go out and buy. I haven't really seen some, and I built one DIY. It's really not that hard to make. You can build one for a lot less than $100. All you need is to build your frame, to add some insulation inside, to add some sound deadening material. I added 2 layers of drywall on this, which made the window plug quite heavy. And then you just add a weather strip around to basically seal the gas. Number 30, acoustic foam. This doesn't really block sound, but it absorbs sound. How this will work, it will make the room sound better. And what this will do, it will help drown out the noise. It's not gonna eliminate it, but it will make it not as high pitch. And if you actually fill the entire room with it, it will be enough to make a noticeable difference in volume coming from the room outside. I would personally use a 2-inch acoustic foam if I would be adding it inside a room. They're a little bit more expensive than the 1-inch. But the 1-inch doesn't work that well. 24 for around $50 or less. Now, number 32 is an extension to that. They're bass traps. Now, if you have a lot of bass inside the room, if you have a lot of echoes, well, the sound waves, they bounce all around the wall. If you add these in the corner, it helps. For a pack of 10, they're around $20. Number 32, acoustic panels. They're a little bit more expensive than acoustic foam, but one good thing is that you can build these DIY. You can build these with wooden frames, a little bit of insulation inside, and add a fabric backing. And these works a lot better at absorbing noise than acoustic foam. They range from $60 to around $100 each. Next one is acoustic wallpaper. The only thing that this does is it helps to absorb a little bit of the noise inside the room. If you don't have much on the wall and you have a lot of echo and you like wallpaper, then this is something to think about. It's more rubbery, where you can kind of push your nail inside it, than just regular wallpaper. Acoustic wallpaper, or some people call it soundproofing wallpaper. It's not really soundproofing wallpaper. It's not going to stop a lot of noise coming from the other room. If that's your objective, then skip the wallpaper. Next one is acoustic diffusers. Acoustic diffusers are a little bit different than acoustic panels. What they do is they scatter sound waves to reduce echo and create a balanced acoustic environment, common in recording studios and home theaters. Number 36, soundproof underlayment. Now, this type of underlayment, you install it underneath the floor to help with impact noise. It'll help absorb every footsteps. But this stuff will cost between 50 cents to $2 a square foot. Number 37, acoustic ceiling tiles. Ceiling tiles that are thicker, denser, heavier, and will not only absorb noise, but will also help block noise. It won't completely soundproof the ceiling. It's just that if you have a drop ceiling, this does help compared to just regular ceiling tiles that are quite cheap. Number 38 is a solid core door. Typically in your house, you'd have a hollow core door, which in the middle of the door, you'd have a honeycomb cardboard piece just to hold the door in place, basically. But it doesn't really stop that much noise. A solid core door instead is filled with a piece of something that looks like compressed sawdust, but it does work pretty well at blocking more noise than a hollow core door. And it's about double the price, and it does stop more noise than a hollow door. If you do want to go a step further, you can buy a solid wood door. These doors are more expensive, usually between $500 to $1,000 depending on the door, but it will stop more noise than a solid core door. The only thing is, it is extremely heavy because the hinges will probably not be able to support the added weight of a solid wood door. Now, if you want to go a step even further from that, is a fiberglass door. A lot of the exterior doors are fiberglass doors. The way it's constructed does help stop even more sound than, in a lot of cases, a solid wood door. Number 43, interlocking floor mats. Now, these interlocking floor mats are a little bit different than the ones that you would just typically buy for a baby or a toddler for them to play on so they don't hurt themselves. These are a little bit thicker, they're heavier, and they are made specifically to absorb noise. It does a great job at absorbing a lot of the jumping noise that you will be doing. A lot of that structural noise will be absorbed into that mat, and it'll just make it so you don't bother people underneath you. You can buy a pack of 16 for about $35. Number 44 is cork flooring. Now, cork flooring is a type of underlayment like the ones I was talking earlier, but it's not the same as the soundproof underlayment. It's a little bit cheaper at around $135 for about 200 square foot. It will help in absorbing some of that impact noise, the vibrational noise of the footsteps, of anything that's going on upstairs. It will help. Number 45 is soundproof joist tape. Put this type of tape on every joist, and then you screw the wooden planks right through the joist tape. Then it will make it so that the screw doesn't starts to untighten as time goes on and starts to get loose, which will usually make squeak. It will make it so the screw stays in place, will not squeak. Number 46, acoustic clouds. Now, acoustic clouds, they are attached to the ceiling to make the room sound a lot better, to completely get rid of the echo. A lot of times you'll see these in big open office buildings, but I have seen it work very well in houses that has high ceilings, especially the houses with the big A-frame and a lot of windows. A lot of the times it's very difficult to get rid of the echoes that travels up that height, and adding acoustic foam and acoustic panels on the ceilings doesn't look that well. Acoustic clouds will range in price between around $50 to $200 for really nice ones. Number 48 is ceiling vibration dampening mounts. So what you would use these for is to hang, let's say, water pipes. Instead of the water pipes touching the wall, so every time water goes or any types of vibration in the pipes would flow through, you wouldn't hear it as much, or at least you wouldn't feel the vibration if you have the pipes hanging on these isolation clips. And you can buy a 4-pack of these for around $20. Number 49, let's stick with the piping, with noise dampening pipe and duct tape. This noise dampening wrap consists of flexible foil face mass loaded vinyl barrier laminated to a quilted fiberglass absorber decoupler with reinforced foil on the outer side. So it's pretty self-explanatory. If you have a pipe that's, well, especially a water pipe, that's creating a lot of headache for you, wrap it around and a lot of that noise will be absorbed and also blocked. And number 50, it is a vibration dampening foil tape. If you have an HVAC system and you have vibration in them, you can open the vents and just place the tape inside. They are rated from minus 25 degrees Fahrenheit to 175 degrees Fahrenheit. They work pretty well at eliminating some of the vibration coming from your HVAC system. Now there you have it, 50 products that you could actually buy and use to help soundproof a room. But there it is, 50. Now if you want to know how to soundproof a room on a budget, watch this video. Hopefully you enjoyed that video as well, just like you enjoyed this one. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time, assuming that you subscribed.